Sportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. Esportsbets.com, foresight, passion, and calculation.
Everybody who's woken up and enjoying their breakfast with us here on the channel. I'm here with Ven, and Ven, we've already seen HellRaisers take their first match of the day versus myXMG. It was on Dust 2, but what did you make of the performance so far today?
HellRaisers definitely looked better on Dust 2 today than what they did versus Na'Vi last night, so that's a great sign for them going into the next map, and obviously, potentially, the rest of the tournament. And I'll have to say that I think HellRaisers are favored going into the next map, which is going to be Inferno, because they did put up a pretty good performance versus Na'Vi on Inferno last night. So if they sorted out their mistakes on Dust 2, where they got kind of pummeled by Na'Vi, then who's to say they haven't sorted out some of their tiny or smaller mistakes on Inferno as well?
Ah, very true. I mean, that's the thing we have to look for here. We have to see if HellRaisers are going to be up to snuff, because they are fighting their way through the lower bracket. This is the loser match of the lower bracket, everybody. So the team to lose here is going to be the first team out of the Star Series 10 LAN. It's four teams invited, but myXMG, HellRaisers, nobody, neither of these teams wants to be the first team out. So myXMG are now fighting for their tournament lives here on Inferno. But you're right, man. HellRaisers definitely put up a fight versus Na'Vi on Inferno yesterday. Adrian with a clean 3 kills to secure the knife round will be giving them the strong start on the CT side as well. So myXMG, life doesn't get any easier for them. They have to start off strong on the T side of Inferno now.
They absolutely do. Absolutely do. But we've seen teams get off to hot streaks on the T side as well. Actually, I think that's been something we've seen quite often as of late. People getting up to that 5-0 start, and from there on out, a lot of the times it feels like everything you get from that point on is kind of gravy on the T side. Even though we talk about Inferno being one of the more balanced maps in the map pool, if you get off to such a hot start and you quickly get to, let's say, 7 rounds, 6 rounds, you're going to feel good about yourself, and it kind of drives you forward, and you get a good flow in your game, and it's easier, in a sense, to pick up rounds. Or that's the kind of feeling you're sitting here left with after watching a team getting off to a hot streak on their T side.
Well, so hell, even in that situation yourself, you can feel it, right? You know, it takes that pressure off of your shoulders. And especially if you're on the least favored side, right? If you're on the CT side of Dust 2, or you're on the T side of Inferno, and you've picked up the pistol, you get the 3 rounds, and then you go into the 4th round, the first hurdle, the first buy round for your opponents, and you crush that too, you feel like $1 million going into the rest of it.
Oh, yeah. And there is definitely something to the fact when, obviously, in the first 5 rounds, you're not going to have the biggest variety of strategies that you've run up to that point, but you're gonna get a good feel of what's working for you and what's not working for you. So if, let's say, your B take is working swimmingly and you've pretty much just lost one or two guys on every execute you've had towards that bomb site, you're gonna feel so much more confident to go back there and continue to do more work towards that B bomb site. And once you're not afraid to push through, well, while flashed or through a smoke, if you've got stuff prepared for that, it's going to do a lot for your team to actually get onto a site and actually catch the defenders off guard for in a way. So that could do a lot for you, basically just riding off that momentum and that confidence boost you get from those early rounds to work with as the first half chugs along.
No, it makes a huge difference. It definitely makes a huge difference. But HellRaisers, we can't forget that they've just come off of a win from Dust 2. They got their game together towards the end of it as well when they switched over to that T side. Really started to get the pressure up, and we could start to see, you know, cleaner play, more confidence coming out in their game. So they're definitely going to be a team going into this second map with all the advantages, basically being up 1-0 in a series and knowing that they're capable of taking the kills that they need versus myXMG, who had some very good 1v3s actually on Dust 2, But once HellRaisers identified what they were doing wrong, which was basically being greedy and peeking and giving myXMG opportunities, once HellRaisers figured that out and eliminated that from their game, they looked like a very solid team indeed. They closed out the rest of the map in pretty fine fashion. So we have to see if they're going to have that same confidence, that same level of play here on Inferno, where it's all going to be settled here. Who gets to go on to face off against Na'Vi in the consolidation final? Na'Vi losing to Fnatic in the winner bracket final. That was our last best of three of last night. Fnatic are now waiting in the grand finals of this tournament. So Na'Vi are next for whoever goes through here, and Fnatic are waiting in the grand finals later on today, which should be starting around 18 CET, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. Obviously, barring any small delays and whatnot. Hopefully, yesterday just went through extremely smoothly. I don't think we had a single delay. We finished well in time of the schedule.
It's not like the CS days of old, right? You know, it's been a long time. It feels like it's been a long time where we've been like, oh, we're 15 minutes late, but that's normal, right? Because it's CS.
Oh yeah, even an hour would be CS appropriate, I guess.
Yeah, but we're getting spoiled now, or at least what I feel like is that the teams are getting more professional. But okay, enough of that. We're getting to the pistol round here. First round of this half, and already Doja getting dinked to the face to start off. You know, they went for an aggressive peek down mid HellRaisers with two guys at the top of quad looking towards T-spawn, and myXMG promptly punished them. So I do like that already from myXMG. Quite a few nades on it, myXMG as well. Hunden and MSL making the investment, getting flashes and smokes. And it does look like it's going to be a B play after all. They're all gathering up here, myXMG, for this B take, and we'll have to see if they can overwhelm the defense. It's going to be down to Adrian, point man here on the B site, with Angel to watch his back.
Yeah, this is going to be pretty standard B push. We're going to see smokes for coils and spawn here. And HellRaisers haven't made the proper rotations.
Wow, and they die instantly as well. Angel taking shots right away, drops him, and Adrian is going to get caught through the smoke. Tenski, two big kills. He gets the entry on Angel and then predicts where Adrian is going to be, catches him getting ready in flowers, and now that's a two-man advantage here for myXMG. This bomb has been planted as well. HellRaisers finally on the scene, and now it comes down to whether myXMG can weather the storm. MSL picking off Markloff. Hunden finds Doja, and it's going to be Kocher, last man alive, towards construction. Gets one headshot, but he is now in a 1v4 situation, and MSL has no fear. They're hunting him down. He's going for the burst fire, and he gets the frag. myXMG, the perfect start here on Inferno with this T start.
Two huge entry frags coming up from Tenski right there. And even though it's a super vanilla B take from myXMG, if you get that entry frag, it's so hard for HellRaisers to do anything about it. Hell, even if you just allow myXMG to get down the proper smokes and proper flashes, it's really hard to hold because, well, you don't have a rifle and you have limited amount of needs to actually work with in the pistol round. So great, great work from myXMG, making the most out of their opportunity. I actually think the B bomb site is probably one of the more lucrative ways to go about it in a pistol round when you opt for nades like that.
I mean, when you get the nades, and then also, you know, it's more of a focused site, and there's only going to be, in general, two guys to holding there, right?
Yeah.
So if you get all five bodies up there really quick behind the flashes, it is, I mean, hell, man, you know the YOLO B. Why do I call it every single time we matchmake, right? Because, man, the YOLO train is great. It's unstoppable.
It works.
B site all day, every day. You have it from me, everybody.
And I like what myXMG are doing right now. They're basically just walking up into mid. And if you're playing a team that's probably going to play passively and hold angles, you might as well go on contact. And that's what they've done. So they've basically gotten the site for free. All they need to do is limit the damage that Doja and Markloff can do at the start of this. So if Hunden gets picked up here, that could be an issue actually for myXMG.
But now they're making away with the Galil as well.
Yeah, but now they know at least, and knowing is half the battle.
Well, they have MSL and Kevin both watching towards apartments now, making sure that Doja can't peek out and get more damage done. Although there's the flash, and MSL will drop to Doja. Kevin is now caught in a crossfire as well. Markloff pressuring him from short. Kevin finds the headshot there, and Doja is yet to pick him off. PNX is still alive in pit, and HellRaisers, they're running out of time here. They have a kit on Kucher, but they just don't have the time to be able to get onto this site and get the job done. They're looking to get exits now, pick off the members from IXMG, and make sure they go up with the bomb. Only two members surviving here for the Danes, PNX and Tenski, so that was a very successful eco round there from HellRaisers.
It definitely was, especially saving that Galil on Doja. That's going to potentially do a lot of work for them. But still, myXMG do pick up the round, and with the recent trends after seasons we're introduced to the game, picking up an anti-eco feels like a bit of an accomplishment at this point.
It's high pressure, right? You gotta be terrified of going around every damn corner.
And speaking of going around corners, HellRaisers are working on a bit of a stack towards the A here, so if myXMG opts to do something similar to what they did in the previous round, which is basically walk up mid and around arch and quad, they might be in for a bit of a uneasy surprise.
I also like what the HellRaisers have done here. I mean, they've put the rifle over with Doja on B site. So if they do decide to funnel through here, Doja could have a good opportunity to do quite a bit of damage. myXMG are going to have to be on point. But another thing to note is that HellRaisers have heavily invested in smokes this round. Across the board, everybody rocking a smoke nade. And that's really going towards shutting off this B site from myXMG. That's two smokes now that have gone down over here. And the rotation now to follow. HellRaisers are going to have the defense here. And myXMG, with 45 seconds left on the clock, they look intense to take this site.
I actually think if myXMG doesn't do anything about this, they're going to run into this awkward situation where they have to push through smokes, and that's going to be awful with the stack from HellRaisers coming out.
Yeah, look at Kucher's position. He's got the perfect flank. He's going to get a triple kill, and he's still alive. Kucher, he picks up an AK as well. This is going to be a fantastic position for him. He's got Kevlar. He's got a kit. Now Kucher is in a fantastic... I mean, he is right here waiting around the corner. Kucher's going to peek, gets another frag. It's going to be Angel actually taking it, but the Kucher will roll in for the final frag on PNX. 4K for Kucher on a very mixed, weird buy from HellRaisers, but they make it work. His positioning couldn't have been more perfect.
That was stars aligning for HellRaisers right there. The setup they wanted to go for worked out perfectly. I definitely think myXMG got caught off by the fact that they had four smokes committed to that B-bomb site. That definitely messed with their heads. And Kucher, obviously. I thought it might have been Doja who would come up big in that round with the Galil, but doesn't really matter who comes up big for your team as long as someone does it. So Kucher with the 4K, definitely saving HellRaisers and bringing them around back. And we just talked about it, right? Winning an anti-eco round kind of feels like an accomplishment because it's so hard to do these days. And HellRaisers show why it's so hard to actually keep on to those, what we previously regarded as easy rounds.
Yeah, easy rounds to basically get your economy running, right? And now, myXMG, the round before, they lost three guys. That round, they get slaughtered completely. And so, no plant, not holding onto any guns, means they actually have to eco here. So, pistols on myXMG's side, and HellRaisers are kind of playing towards that as well. They're really pushing them all over the place. Doja just with the mad spray, full out. He will get the last kill on PNX as well. So, three kills come in for Doja. One for Adrian, one for Markolov, and a very fine hold indeed here from HellRaisers. A good follow-up. Now, does myXMG have enough to go for a force? And it doesn't look like it. It looks like they really want to take their time because we're still very early on in the half here. So there's no reason for them to take any big risks. I feel like if this was HellRaisers or NiP, they would buy. You know.
And that's something I would have been strongly opposed to. Simply because you're on 2-2. If you're on the T side, this is a pretty okay start for you. You're still doing better than the CT side, I would say. So forcing it up now, that's jeopardizing two more rounds. And you don't want to do that this early on.
Yeah, I agree wholeheartedly here. Kucher, Doja, Markolov, everybody. Well, they have a bit of a barbecue at quad as myXMG try to walk around there. So it does not work out for the Danes at all. They hardly get any damage done. And now money is starting to get a little bit out of control on HellRaiser's side. I mean, even after fully buying up here, Kucher's still sitting above 10k. 9k on Doja. That's a lot of bank right now to have this early on in the half on HellRaisers. So myXMG, they have enough for a full buy now. Everybody getting rifles and full nades. No AWP picked up for them. But they have enough left over that if they were to lose this round, if they get a plant, they're going to be buying again. So HellRaisers are going to have to deal with a little bit of pressure out of the T side. But I like how myXMG aren't really wasting too much time here on Banana either. They're really trying to put up a bit of a fight to make sure that HellRaisers don't get this for free. Good nade right there onto Adrian. He eats 50 damage. That's almost as good as it gets. So good damage dealt already to start here at the beginning of the round.
Great damage already. And well, we see so oftentimes, you know, shots going back and forth through these smokes and Banana, and with Adrian being so softened up, he could easily go down just to a random strike from Hunden.
He's going to have to be careful about that. You can already see him just playing passively behind the pillar, not really showing himself, so it wouldn't be an easy frag, Well, we'll have to see exactly where myXMG decided to take this, because they have gathered at top quad right now. They got control of apartments, and Angel and Kucha are waiting on the other side. Molly's going to go in from Kucha, and that drops the bomb. It's right around the corner. Doja up on balcony on the other side of the A site, looking towards short. Will do a little bit of damage and slow down the push from myXMG, but myXMG are getting bogged down right now. And the problem is that there's four guys from HellRaisers here. They need to find some frags fast, and Hunden will step in and pick off Angel, reducing the defense to three. They try and wrap around, but guess who's still waiting in banana? It's going to be Adrian, but now he's only at half health, and that's not going to help him. He gets overwhelmed, and myXMG have hit the perfect timing to take this B site.
Oh, they really have. And if they can get into good afterplant positions, this is going to be such a hard retake for HellRaisers. And you can see PNX is already... Well, actually, he moves back from Ruins there. I would like to see him go into Ruins or try to get control over that area as well. But they seem to have a pretty good lockdown on the area regardless. And HellRaisers are well aware of that fact and are deciding to back off.
Minimal nades on HellRaisers as well, actually. Doja, only one flash. Kucher, nothing left. Markolov used his only HE. So... it seems like rather than attempt the retake at 3-on-4, HellRaisers are going to opt to save their guns. And yeah. Really, you can't fault them too much for it. I mean, it's still early on in the half as well. If they lose all these guns, I think they're really just trying to stretch their economy as far as possible, because they do have really sick banks, so they could afford to go for an attempt at it.
Yeah, they definitely could have afforded it. But then again, it is expensive being CTs on this side. And if you get into a bit of a bad streak in the middle of the game, it could really hamper you to the point where you have to double eco and stuff like that. And all of a sudden, myXMG could get 5, 6, 7 rounds out of the blue. And that's definitely something you don't want. So this is HellRaisers just playing as safely as possible. And I don't really mind them doing it.
No, safe, smart play. Maybe not like super exciting, but it's smart play. And that's exciting in its own way. So... it's going to be, again, a battle for banana. Angel, instant headshot, and Angel will pick up both kills at top banana. myXMG just getting slapped down, and that's the start HellRaisers were looking for in the last round when we had that long duel there. So HellRaisers managing to get quite a bit of control already, and they're even willing to play a bit aggressive at mid. Kevin is going to get spotted out from Doja. He was jumping around an underpass, and that's going to be good information because that spots the bomb as well. So now HellRaisers have an idea of where the bomb is, at least. They know that it's in mid. It's not up in apartments or second mid. Or at least as far as they know. Now it's in second mid, guys. I know you guys can see the minimap. We have the eye in the sky, so it's a bit of, you know, it's cheating a little bit.
And it seems like myXMG are content on actually committing to this A bomb site, although it's kind of half-heartedly with Kevin playing so passively down in second mid. It kind of leaves Tenski all by himself up in midair to do a lot of work if he wants to break through that HellRaisers defense. And I wouldn't be too surprised if we saw myXMG actually go back towards B in hope to pick up an aggressive Adrian, because that could give them the bomb site, actually, because Angel's gonna have to react quickly.
I would actually like to see Angel fall back to the B site, really. Now, I mean, they've got a two-man lead, or three-man lead rather. It's like, why not just play it as safely as possible? And now he starts to come back to that site, but there's only 9 seconds left, and myXMG have already made the decision to just save their guns.
Yeah, I think Adrian also made a pretty smart decision. Instead of as time runs down, he realizes as well. And a potential execute has to come at some point very soon, so I might as well back off, put down the smoke at the entrance to B, and basically just hold from sight. And that's when Angel decided to rotate over as well. So HellRaisers are playing it fairly safely, and you can see that myXMG are not willing to take any unnecessary risks given their economy either.
Yeah, this is where we really see the importance of the economy in CSGO. It's, you know, the frags are important, but your money is sacrosanct. And now Adrian is going to get caught behind the bags. He's going to get picked up for free. Angel right around the corner takes one with him, but this is now the B site firmly in myXMG's grasp. Kucher is going to be the man holding from CT spawn, but look at PNX this time around. He gets right into construction, doesn't waste any time at all. He's got a man backing him as well, and PNX is going to be in a terrific position. Kucher walks in, takes out his teammate, but PNX gets that one for free. Markolov walks into it as well, and it's the blender. Doja will finally remove him, but it's a 1v2, and myXMG still have the advantage in this situation.
Oh, definitely. I would like to see Hunden back off, actually, from this point, so Tenski can actually play with his teammate. But it works out in the end. But that could have potentially been scary, because the way Hunden has placed himself makes it so Doja has the opportunity to get to 1v1s instead of 1v2, which is obviously a lot harder. So, yeah, kind of scary from myXMG, but they make it work and they pick up that fourth round. And I think that's largely due to PNX there with a 4k. getting those through entry frags, kind of reminiscent of how Freiburg does his work in Banana as well.
Yeah, Freiburg, the master, the king of Banana. You're right, PNX, I mean, that was some very good play from him, and I really like the aggression from him as well, getting into construction so early like that. And we could see it just worked out perfectly. Kucher pushes in, takes out his teammate, thinks that he's clear, and then walks right into PNX, and Markeloff, no better luck either. So already we've had some action at the beginning of this round, the ninth. It's a 4-on-4 situation, and myXMG gearing up for a bit of an A play for now. We do have Angel waiting in noob corner. He's going to be the first line of defense here with Markeloff to support from short, and Doja as well on balcony. There's quite a good defense here for HellRaisers. Everybody here from HellRaisers, in fact, they've given up the B site. They know this is going to be an A play, and Adrian, watching from Arch, is going to be the point man to draw people out for Angel, and there you go. The crossfire blunder is done, and this is not going to work out for myXMG. Doja will find the last one on Tensky and A apartments, but the push-up quad, that was about as clean as it gets for HellRaisers.
That was so fortunate, though. MSL, it looked like he had a hunch that someone was hiding in the noob corner in Arch, and he was kind of contemplating whether or not he wanted to smoke it off and see if he could get a reaction from it, but instead decided to peek towards the connector, and as soon as he gets peeked out, but I think it was Adrian who rotated over from B, as soon as he gets peeked out from them, that's kind of the go signal for Angel to wreak havoc, and he does.
Double nade down Banana works well, and then Angel is there to clean up. He's gonna get three frags. Can he get the ace? Now we see he gets one, and he gets all. He gets them all. Five kills for Angel in the anti-eco beatdown. That's how you want an anti-eco to go. You gotta pad the stats a little bit, make a little bit of money, but also, you know, just not lose a man.
Yeah, not lose a man. Gain some confidence on Angel, and he's gonna be feeling good about himself. Even though it's an eco, definitely feels good to mow down the entire team by yourself.
Oh yeah, that's that confidence boost that you're looking for, and that's the confidence boost that actually myXMG do not want to be giving to HellRaisers right now, because HellRaisers, they've maintained their money, they haven't been forced to eco yet, and they've got the lead in rounds. So it's myXMG who are actually financially pressured at this point, not able to afford to buy up full nades, for example, and even having Hunden only with a Galil. So Hunden is going to be taking point top Banana. Angel, we'll find that headshot. MSL strikes right back, though, so a good one-for-one trade, actually, that's going to favor myXMG in the end.
I actually think it favors them for more than one reason, because I think Hunden was the one guy who was kitted out with a Galil on that team, so that's trading a Colt for a Galil as well, which is an added benefit if you're myXMG.
They're kind of split up right now, though, myXMG. They've got two guys in apartments and two guys in Banana, and it seems like they're still trying to see if they can't get a favorable trade at some point. Kucher gets flashed into Banana, takes the fight with MSL, and somehow comes out on top. He's going to walk right into Kevin, though. So again, one for one at top of Banana, and now the rest of myXMG are going to start rotating over towards this B site. There is still Adrian alive, but he's been pushed back into CT spawn. And myXMG are just throwing HellRaisers for a loop everywhere. Markeloff is kind of halfway through, but he is going to be back in library by the time this push wraps around Arch. Oh, and a great entry there from PNX on Doja. Picks him off of the balcony. Markeloff alive in library. Tries to find PNX out in the open. He's going to miss the timing just barely. And PNX has to be so careful. Don't give Markeloff a shot. You just have to hold. And the smoke goes down. And now life gets very difficult here for HellRaisers. It's a 2-on-2 retake of A. But that smoke is buying so much time. And it's funneling HellRaisers towards short, towards pit, where PNX is holding. Yeah. Gets the first frag on Adrian. Makes it look easy. And Markeloff now alone. Caught in a crossfire as well. As soon as he pushes past this point, Kevin should be able to light him up. That sets it up for PNX. And Markeloff, he's only got 4 points of health. Kevin has to get the shot. He's going to whiff the first one, but gets the second. And Kevin saves it just barely for myXMG.
It works out in the end. But they do take pretty substantial losses in that round. So you can see their buy is going to be pretty hampered with three Galils already. And I wouldn't be too surprised, actually, if we saw, well, actually, I was about to say PNX picking up a Galil as well to get some extra nades. But then again, he's been kind of the point man for myXMG these last few rounds. So maybe they want him kitted out with an AK so he can actually get that one shot in on a potential entry.
It seems like the answer here for myXMG is going to be pushing aggressively. Angel and Adrian just turn the top of Banana into a slaughterhouse, and they will just make it look so clean. Angel with the pop flash that works perfectly. Not sure if we caught that pop flash, but Angel, he just dinked it off the wall and it landed right at myXMG's face, or feet, right? All four of them blinded, and then he just turns that into a a wall of lead that they're walking into. That's really unfortunate for myXMG. They were really looking to see if they could just catch HellRaisers off guard with just outright aggression right from the start. And once again, HellRaisers are good. They shut it down.
Yeah, their setup really on that B bomb site has been working out pretty well for them. Even though myXMG have gotten in a couple of times, when Adrian and Angel get into position, it seems to be really hard to actually break through that.
Well, they're playing that tag team so well together. Again, arch play here from myXMG. Pistols in hand, and they are going to get obliterated. Markloff and Kuchar splitting it. 3 for Kuchar, 2 for Markloff. But that's that tag team duo over on the B side, it's almost like Olafmeister Krim sort of stuff, where they just seem to be so in tune with one another, with the flashes, with covering angles, with making sure that they're watching each other's backs. It really is a pleasure to watch HellRaisers play this well on the B side right now for Inferno. And just, this is kind of like what we expect to see out of HellRaisers, really, you know, with the kind of talent that's on this team. We do expect to see this level of teamwork now, at least, after the bumpy start that this team has had at the very beginning of its formation, when it was kind of everybody playing for themselves, not really playing too much with the teamwork. Now it seems like they've started to come together.
They're definitely doing a good job of, well, as you said, playing kind of the tag team play style, and we saw that in the last anti-eco push, up in mid. Just now, so now we're gonna see it again. Doja picking up the first frag on Hund, and it actually gets taken out by PNX. Markloff though retaliates for the kill on MSL, and myXMG have gotten pretty good position here in pit, and PNX has also gotten a weapon. And he's gonna take out two players from HellRaisers, and this leaves the bomb side open. If they can actually manage to deal with Kuchar up in apps right now, this is very doable for myXMG.
Well, that's the main problem. And the other problem is that PNX was the bomb carrier there for myXMG, and he got caught in pit. Kuchar doesn't let him get out in time. And now it's going to be the same thing here. Tensky trying to get out through truck. Adrian is going to walk up, find him. Perfect timing. Gets the headshot. Saves the off from Markloff. That was actually good damage dealt, however, by myXMG. Still managing to pick up 3 members there for HellRaisers. Even if they didn't get a plant, they will have enough money to go for a full buy here in this round.
Yeah, it looked like a bit of a Cinderella story as it was playing out, with PNX picking up those 2 frags in quad, but Kuchar coming out quickly from behind in naps. That made all the difference for HellRaisers. So it was a bit of a gory ending to the Cinderella story in that case. Not quite the Disney ending we were looking for.
But Doja goes for a SCAR 20. This isn't something we see every day. This is something that's very rare indeed.
As well. This could get risky, because if he gets caught out in a wonky position, he could get picked off really quickly, and that's something myXMG could run with.
Yeah, agreed. It's usually the SCAR 20 you want to hold it at a bit of a distance, or you pull it like Exist does, where you hold it top quad, looking down mid, looking towards second mid, right? There's enough of an angle for you to be able to get out of harm's way if you miss those first shots. Whereas Doja, up close like that in apartments, if they rush you down, you're not going to last too long unless you can get the perfect shot to start.
Yeah, it pretty much falls on you landing the 2 initial shots instantly. And if not, you're going to start to scramble quite a bit.
All right, I like this position better here. He's changed it up. He's gone back to graveyard. Yeah. So put a little bit more distance between himself and the rush position.
It's definitely a better position to play it from, in my opinion. I'm kind of curious to see what myXMG are doing right now. They're just posturing up on, well, every spot of the map right now, and it seems like it might be a B fake here. They're going to try to sell with Thunden.
They're waiting too long, though. 20 seconds left. I mean, that's all they have here. Angel will pick off the first man through Hunden towards that B site, and Doja will react in time, pick up the kill on Tensky, trying to make his play through A apartments, but MSL will return on him. Markloff looking to stop this plant from happening. He gets a point-blank shot on PNX. Very nicely done there by Markloff. Kevin is the last man alive here from myXMG, trying to find the angle to work. He's doing the damage, but he's not finding the kills. And now he actually manages to back off towards short. There is going to be Adrian waiting for him around the corner, and Markloff is actually going to be the man to hunt him down. Well, that was a bit touch and go there for a moment. If Kevin just landed a couple more shots, that could have been big.
Yeah, if he found the same person each and every time he landed a hit, because he kind of split his damage between Markloff and Kuchar. And if he takes down Markloff in that situation, then obviously that gives him some room at least to work with, and he could probably get into a bit of a better position. But I'm not sure, did you watch Doja that round with the auto sniper?
Did you see that?
Yeah, it looked like it was AFK for a while.
I was wondering myself, I'm like, okay, he saw him once. Okay, yeah. He saw him twice. No reaction at all. And then finally he reacts when the guy's already shooting at him. That was very weird.
Yeah, I was thinking to myself, oh, did Doja time out? like did his PC crash or something? Because that would have been horrible if he doesn't pick up that one frag on the guy coming out from apps. I think it was Tenski maybe came running out of apps. But yeah, he does pick up that one kill, and Markolov finishes it off with a 3K. So HellRaisers just get the 10-5 halftime score. And I actually think myXMG are perfectly okay with this. Although they got those five rounds, or they got off to a pretty good start, obviously winning the pistol and the first anti-eco. With how well HellRaisers just played and how little myXMG actually got done in their own ecos, I think they have to be okay with the result going into the second half.
I agree. This is, I mean, five rounds is feasible. If they pick up the pistol round, like a lot of this, again, is going to come down to the pistol round, right? Because that seems to open everything up. But if they can pick up the pistol round here, myXMG, they should win their next three until the 19th round, where we get a bye from HellRaisers. And then, you know, it's kind of all up in the air, but we shall see how things play out. We begin the second half now. HellRaisers on the T side with 10 rounds to their name. myXMG, CT side, five rounds. And looking at what has been bought up, Hunden and Tenski again going with nades, PNX, MSL, Kevlar, and a kit on Kevin. Whereas it seems like Markolov and Angel are the guys who are going to be carrying the nades here for HellRaisers.
Yeah, and well, as of right now, HellRaisers are taking a bit of a passive stance, not pushing too aggressively. Actually, except for Markolov, who's already around in apartments trying to find someone going aggressively, but that's not going to happen for now. And yeah, they've converged a tiny bit towards the banana area where MSL and PNX, not surprisingly, seeing how this is an MSL team playing quite aggressively in banana. But yeah, I think HellRaisers might do something similar to what we saw myXMG do in their pistol rounds.
That seems like the go-to strat. I mean, it's a smart strat to go for as well. They've got two smokes, they've got two flashes. You've got a smoke for coils, a smoke for CT, and then two flashes to go onto the site to clear the way. This could be it, but we already have myXMG rotating a third man over here. Hunden is on speedway to support the cross, and HellRaisers are going to go for this play now. MSL has been smoked off into flowers. Hunden is just going to go rushing through. He could have a golden opportunity here, and already point blank drops the bomb carrier, but it's a 2-on-4 situation. The rest of his teammates fall, and HellRaisers is now in a terrific position to pick up this pistol round, which would be a calamity for myXMG.
Oh, it absolutely would, and it's unfortunate for myXMG that none of the guys initially holding the B bomb site picks up a frag, and Markolov with the CZ putting in the pain onto Kevin, and Doja picks off Tenski to clear it out. But I think if MSL or whoever he was with on that B bomb site picks up just one more frag on the initial push, that could do a lot for them, because Hunden actually does what he needs to do when he barges through the smoke and picks up that one frag in the pool area. I think that's more than enough from him, but we needed to see one of the guys on B from myXMG pick up at least one more frag to give Kevin and Tenski the opportunity to actually do something in the retake.
Yeah.
And actually, it seems like the teams are kind of copying each other, because right now we're seeing, well, Doja managed to save a Galil from their first eco, but we can see four smokes picked up on myXMG here, so wouldn't be too surprised if we saw them stacking up with the smokes towards banana to kind of funnel them in towards the bomb site.
Well, they've got the smokes, but they've still only got three guys here on this A site. They are kind of poised to go towards B quickly as well. myXMG now spreading out somewhat. PNX is going to land a good dink there onto Kucher and get the kill in the end. Angel with two kills, however, one with the MAC-10 and one with an HE, and that's going to leave Tenski as the last man alive on this A site. He has gotten into a pretty smart position up in A apartments, though, so it's going to make it difficult to root him out of there. MSL closing in, and the rotation coming in from Hunden as well. But HellRaisers have now got control of this site, and they've got the bomb plant as well. Doja will find MSL trying to push through the smoke, and that never really works.
Yeah, and Tenski got spotted out by Angel as well from apartments, so he doesn't feel safe about walking out there. And with him having to, well, swap out his position, he's not going to be able to be in a position to punish any of the HellRaisers members.
In the end, three members living. Actually, I'd say that's a pretty good anti-ego for HellRaisers. I mean,
yeah.
myXMG, they kill two, so they're going to make HellRaisers spend some money. I think perhaps they had the opportunity there to get at least three.
Oh, they definitely did. And I think in HellRaisers' case, as long as you survive with three people or more, that's a successful anti-eco. In a sense, obviously you'd like to have everyone alive and all that, but that's really hard to do with the firepower that the CTs can actually get with so little investment.
Well, let's see how things shape up here. HellRaisers quickly taking control of Banana. They're going to make sure that they've got all the room to work with here. Smoke goes down from MSL. So myXMG, once again, setting up with the smoke. So they're making these investments. They're spending basically, well, 300 on Hunden and PNX. MSL had a smoke of his own, so he invested 6. And Kev's with 3. So they are kind of managing their money here. It's only MSL who's going to get who's going to spend the extra bit. So they're really looking to have as strong a buy round as possible in the 19th round that will be coming up next here from myXMG. But they're not out of the woods yet here, HellRaisers. I mean, still, three guys stacked up on this B site. Angel could get greedy and try and put this MAC-10 to use, but if he runs in there, I mean, two CZs is going to hurt. Or it's just the one. It's just the one. Tenski's on the other side.
It's still going to hurt a lot more than his MAC-10, I think.
Agreed. I mean, he could be instantly caught here. We're going to have the smokes going in, and this is going to cut things up. The flash is in as well, and now does he have the opportunity? Nope. Hunden point blank with the P2K will double headshot him to the face, pick up that MAC-10, and he's going to be able to put it to use now. MSL is still alive, and not for long. Doja finds him through the smoke, and Markloff will pick off Kevs in the meantime. It comes down to Tenski now alive on the site. He's going to find the first frag. He gets a second one as well. He's already done the damage. Tenski's still here going for more. Nearly drops Adrian down. And PNX is now the man trying to close the gap as quickly as possible. Doja still alive, however, with full HP, looking down short. Catches him as he rounds the corner. But that was definitely a round won by myXMG. 3 kills going through once again. HellRaisers having to spend money in the follow-up round.
A good eco. And it was so close to being even better. If Tenski picks up Adrian there on site and leaves Doja in a 2v1. That could easily swing the favor of myXMG because Tenski still had bullets, or obviously would have had to reload, but he still would have had one more clip on his CZ. And as long as he does damage to Doja in that situation, that leaves PNX with the opportunity to get a potential one dink with his P2000.
Yep.
So really close round, actually, from myXMG. Unfortunate that they couldn't make it work all the way, but still, they're going to be happy about that.
I'm really impressed right now. Tenski with the perfect play, really. Getting the two, even just getting the two is huge.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
He was in the right space, you know, to be able to put that CZ to good use.
One more than you need to get, I guess. In an ideal world, everyone gets one kill it every round, right?
Alright, well now we have to see exactly where HellRaisers are going to take this, because HellRaisers do like to pace themselves on the T side, and they know that myXMG have bought up with rifles now. It being the 19th round, myXMG have got a very long way ahead of them, though. They aren't out of this yet, but they need to start off strong. And MSL finding the angle on Doja towards Banana, it's going to force HellRaisers to reconsider this bomb site. Do they want to take this fight after all? Oh, this nade. Money nade? No, it does zero damage to Markloff. He actually messes it up. And that's Markloff getting a bit of a lucky break there. That nade would have dropped him down to 40 HP for sure. And now HellRaisers wrapping around through the A site, making sure that they can get some pressure on here. There's Kevin waiting around the corner, but the pop flash goes in. Kevin not blinded, but Angel forces him around the corner. And this is now just myXMG trying to fall back by as much time as possible. But Kucher finds the first headshot. Markloff gets one as well. PNX is the man alive here in pit, this crucial position. And there's only 7 seconds left on this clock. They stop the bomb, and this is now it. They don't have the time to win this. Kucher in a 1v3. He can't plant the bomb, and Hunden will run into his death, but PNX will get the frag, and that is myXMG securing their 6th round.
I'm feeling bad for Kevin right now, because he did the right move. He managed to hold off the push from Arch, flashes them out, and buys time for his teammates, only to get backstabbed because PNX, for just a tiny bit of time, I don't know, goes into his own world and daydreams as Markloff walks out from maps and picks him off on sight. That was a bit unfortunate to see, but PNX does redeem himself and pick up 3 frags that round, so it works out for myXMG in the end, but it's a rough feeling, especially when Kevin hasn't had the best of games up till this point as well, so you're getting backstabbed because teammates aren't holding the positions they're meant to, that's not the greatest.
It's pain, is what it is, and you're gonna have to bounce back from that. HellRaisers going for a bit of a HellRaisers buy right now, Kucher investing money in this round, picking up an AK of his own. Angel will find a kill with the CZ, though. That's Hunden taken out, but MSL will find Kucher, so the AK has been dropped. It's been picked up by Angel, though. No time wasted there, but Tenski will find him before he can make a getaway, and Markloff gets caught out in the open, but instant headshot from him with that CZ does the damage. This is now 3 kills picked up by HellRaisers, and Markloff will be able to pick up the bomb here as well. It's just on the other side in the smoke.
I actually opts to pick up the Colt instead and go for the kill, which I guess is completely fair in his case. He put the smoke down in quad there. He didn't really have a full overview of what was going on from the myXMG players, so I could definitely see why he wanted to make that a 1v1 instead of randomly, or yeah, just kind of hoping that they're not watching the bomb. But yeah, another round for myXMG. They do lose quite a few members, but still going to be able to get a pretty good buy. Actually, it's only Kevin who's lacking a smoke, and that's about it.
Yeah, that's actually, this is still very reasonable, a very reasonable number of nades to work with here. It's yeah, a near full buy, they've got kits. They decide to skimp on head armor, but when you're dealing with AKs, you're dead anyway. One shot from an AK, whether you have a helmet or not, you're dead. So you can skimp there a little bit.
Yeah, that's $350 saved each round, so definitely worthwhile in the long run of things.
Well, Doja trying to get the entry frag for HellRaisers on B site. He will be forced back, drop down to half health. So a good defense so far from myXMG. Now we have to see if they're going to be able to weather the storm, because HellRaisers still have quite a few nades to put to use here. And they are gathering up for A. With 50 seconds left on this clock now, HellRaisers seems like they want to give themselves a little bit more time. And curious, are they going to be setting up for the smoke play that we've seen them use in the past? No, they're working their way back towards mid. So HellRaisers, what is going to be the call here?
This is going to be the quad push from HellRaisers.
All right, well, they're going for it. They got the smokes down to Arch. Kev once again holding towards Library. He's going to be holding around that angle. Flash goes out. Great flash there. Kevin not able to clinch it. However, he's only going to do half damage to the man pushing up, following. And Angel pushing into pit finds one kill. That's huge. PNX is now caught in the smoke. But Angel knows exactly where he is. Finds him through the smoke completely blind. And now it's all down to MSL in a 1v3. 1v2 now. And with 10 seconds left on the clock, he gets the plant. Doja even makes it into apartments. HellRaisers now in a terrific position. They've got the bomb planted for them. Oh, this nade though. Oh, it's not going to do the kill. It's not going to get the kill. Does he expect Markloff to be there though? Of course not. He has no... He does! He sees it coming! MSL!
That's crazy.
How does he know that Markloff is up there with Doge and even see Markloff?
I think that might have been based on previous information from PNX, maybe, and Pit, that he might have spotted one guy into apps, and when he saw the second guy jumping in, I still think it's crazy that I actually opted to watch for apartments, because I think the logical thing to do from HellRaisers just in that sense is, or the logical thing to expect would be that one of the guys would rotate around to Boiler and would come from Quad, right? So yeah, but MSL makes it work, picks up the 1v3, and saves myXMG's bacon. And you can see that they were definitely hurting, because if they'd lost that round, that would have been eco. You can see Kevin down to FAMAS.
But they're hurting, no doubt about it, Matt. I mean, HellRaisers are on the brink right now, and HellRaisers are just ruthlessly pushing onto this A site this time. Kevin missing a nade there. Nod of the head. But that was a big opportunity there for HellRaisers to put myXMG on the back foot. It's not over yet, though. HellRaisers have now got the bomb planted with three guys left alive. The Triangle of Doom has been formed, and they're going to run right past the man holding in Boiler. This could be a huge opportunity for Doja. He gets one kill, but Hunden does a 180 and shoots him in the face, brings it back to a 2-on-2. Hunden going for this fight on the site. He spots out where Adrian is. Kevin is going to walk into the crossfire, though, and Adrian is going to pick up both remaining frags. myXMG, despite the 1v3 clutch in the last round, cannot clinch it this time, and they are now down to a force buy situation to keep HellRaisers from walking away from this game, taking the win.
It's so unfortunate, because if they would have been able to win that round and deny the bomb plant from HellRaisers, that means that the continuous force buys from HellRaisers would have come back to bite them in the end, and they would have had to eco, finally allowing myXMG to kind of stabilize, because that's what HellRaisers did a really good job of earlier on in the second half, is the fact that myXMG never had the opportunity to actually build up anything reminiscent of a good economy. So they have been forcing up or buying up to the limit each and every round. And now we see the result of it. They're on an eco.
They have to eco right now. And they don't even spend all of their money. They don't go for a full force. They're willing to just go for some CZs, a 5-7 on PNX. Getting fancy, willing to cough up an extra $200. But myXMG are willing to go ahead, take their chances with an eco round here, and then have money left over for a reasonable force buy next round. So at that point, myXMG are saying, we're going to play perfect from here on out.
Yeah, and I guess you can't really fault them, because it's going to be hard to win versus a fully bought Hellraisers when you're only on Pestle and Armor and a couple of nades. So with the way the game has been going up till this point, I can't really fault them for it.
I love how myXMG are using the smokes against Hellraisers as well. Just Hellraisers getting a little bit frustrated there, putting some shots through the smoke, Doja. He's hoping he can get lucky, I guess. I don't know, but he's like, okay, screw it, we're gonna go back to A. Only problem is that myXMG have now rotated off the A site, and somehow Tenski makes it out of there alive and even gets a running headshot on Doja. But with 8 seconds left, Hellraisers will get the plant on an empty A site. myXMG now have to try and work their way in here the hard way. PNX has picked up an AK. But Kucher has already picked up MSL. Kucher alive in the pit. This is a perfect position for him to be holding in as well. He gets the nade dunk, and now it's going to be Tenski alive. Last man here, and he's deciding to back off with that AK.
And then, that was unfortunate. I'm actually surprised that MSL didn't hear the fact that three Hellraisers members kind of just ran off Banana to rotate over towards that A-bomb site. And with that little time left, you kind of have to assume that it's actually going to be pushed towards the A-bomb site. But I guess the mind games are coming into this. And they were really unfortunate not to actually down both Doja and Adrian there. And those two kills would have potentially meant a lot for myXMG. Especially because, well, Hellraisers have been forcing up, and even though they've been getting around and been able to break myXMG's economy, it's not like their own economy is stellar by any means.
No, certainly not. I mean, they're still... I mean, both of these teams are still struggling with the money. It's just that Hellraisers have more of a cushion to work with. I suppose there's a little bit less pressure on them because they still have plenty of rounds. myXMG, they are going to go for that force buy now. Three FAMASs, the AK that they managed to save up on Tenski, and an M4 on PNX. They have to find some perfect shots, though. They have to just obliterate Hellraisers here and keep as many people alive as possible. But Markloff taking point up in A apartments. PNX, not sure if he's been spotted out in bedroom or not, but he's going to get naded down to 39 HP, so he's not feeling too healthy right now. This is going to be PNX taking the fight. MSL and PNX each getting frags. PNX tries to make his exit out of the apartments, but Markloff will shut him down, cut him off before he can get out. But myXMG come out ahead in the exchange. Only PNX has been taken out for myXMG. Hellraisers down to three men. They still have the bomb, but now they have to deal with myXMG being able to spread out their forces a little bit and get two guys on each site.
And I think myXMG are doing pretty much the perfect setup here on the A-bomb site, having two people in pit, just staying together, playing it safely as possible. And I think they're going to be perfectly content in leaving or letting Hellraisers have the opportunity to go through spawn, because you can see Hunden is already ready for that potential threat.
Now, Hunding is pushing over. He's getting closer to the A side as well. He's going to be able to come in through library. This is going to be well timed as well. I mean, Kucher is waiting around the corner to make sure that he can't really see too much of the site. Hunden can still see towards that bomb site. 10 seconds left. The bomb is going to get planted, but he walks right into Kucher. Free kill there. And now it's down to the two remaining members who are alive in pit still, but the smoke is only just now clearing, and you're going to have the nades raining in on them as well. XMG now have to step up big. This is the last round. Hellraiser's one round away from taking it. MSL goes roaring onto the site. Tenski's going to set up the frag, but Adrian and Markloff still live, and Markloff gets the remaining three frags of this round. Hellraisers will take the win 16-8, a 2-0 victory, putting them into the consolidation final. XMG will be going home, taking the fourth place in this tournament. And that's it. Ven, closing thoughts?
Hellraisers definitely looked like a better team today than they did last night. And that's not due to playing up against a weaker opponent or anything like that either, because I think myXMG played way better today than what they did versus Fnatic last night. So both teams show improvement. Hellraisers show the most, and that's really what it came down to. And seems like most of the players on Hellraisers actually showed up to play today, and none of them were really falling behind anyone else. And I think Doja was probably the big story for Hellraisers over in that best of three. And that bodes well for them going into their upcoming game, or the rematch versus Na'Vi, which is going to be a great game.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be good. Just checking the schedule to make doubly sure here, but it will be at 14:30 CET. So pretty much, in an hour and a half, we will be back with our next match on the stream, our next best of three, the consolidation final, to see who will be going home. Hellraisers have bought themselves a second chance here. Na'Vi knocked down from the winner bracket final by Fnatic yesterday evening in our last best of three of the night. they get a chance to get a rematch versus Fnatic now. So we shall find out, guys. It's going to be at 14:30 CET in an hour and a half's time here on the stream. So you don't want to miss it. Go get some lunch. Go stretch your legs. But be back by then.